a muse of fire that would ascend the brightest heaven of invention. A kingdom for a stage, princes to act, and monarchs to behold the swelling sea.
Then the warlike Harry, like himself, assumed the port of Mars, and at his heels, leashed in like hounds, should famine, sword, and fire crouch for employment.
But gentle, and pardons all the flat, unraised spirits that have dared upon this unworthy scaffold to bring forth so great an object.
Can this cockpit hold? The vasty fields of France, or maybe crammed within this wooden O, the very casks that did affright the air at Agincourt.
Oh, pardon, since a crooked figure may attest in place a million, and let us ciphers to this million, to your imaginative forces work.
And suppose, within the girdle of these walls, two mighty monarchies are now contained, whose high upreared and abutting fronts the narrow, perilous ocean parts asunder.
Piece out our imperfections with your thoughts. Into 1,000 parts divide one man, and make imaginary puissance.
Think, when we talk of horses, that you see them bridging their proud hooves in the receding air.
For 'tis now our thoughts that must deck our kings, carry them here and there, jumping over times, turning the accomplishment of many years into an hourglass.
For the which the plan, admit me chorus to this great history, who prologue like your humble patience pray, gently to hear, kindly to judge, our play.
Thank you.
cards answer one knight only. I am Joe.
I am Sam.
And I am Cyrus. And between us, we are going to guide you through this evening's performance.
We can promise you a feast of the very best of the arts at ATS. Music, dance, drama, combined to show all that our peers can do.
We hope that you will be dazzled, moved, amused, and enchanted as over 150 performers, approximately 25% of the school, appear on this stage tonight.
For those of you whom this is your first time visiting HCS at the courtyard, we are sure that you are in for a very big treat. For those of you who may have seen us in Fiddler on the Roof, or Oliver, or Macbeth, or Chicago, you will know that we have taken every opportunity to entertain you in this amazing space, and we are sure that tonight will definitely continue this tradition.
Now, at the moment, decisions on the next big ATS musical have not yet been made. So this is your first chance to have some input. We'll be listening carefully to how all of you react to a number of the items on today's itinerary. And you never know, you may just be influencing what appears next to you on stage.
We open this evening with Shakespeare's famous prologue to Henry V, in which he encourages us, as the audience, to engage our imaginations in order to be taken out of ourselves by the magic of theatre.
This was followed by our appropriate opening number, One Night Only, from the musical of Dreamgirls, by Tom Aaron and Henry Krieger. From our dance ensemble, expertly choreographed by our favourite choreographer, S.J. Matthews, who is the principal of Hereford Academy of Dance and joined us first last year for Chicago.
And so, from dance to jazz, and the first outing this evening for the HCS Jazz Band. Now this is a relatively new ensemble, formed by Mr. Barlow just last year, which in its first few appearances has quickly gained a sparkling reputation and brought a new sense of cool to the music department. Now ladies and gentlemen, with But Not For Me, from Crazy Girl by George Gershwin, please give a big hand to the Jazz Band.
Will you love the light below?
This evening we're joined by the wonderful vocals of Fifi Preston and the talents of our dance ensemble. Our next two numbers will also feature remarkable vocalists. Last year, Cassie Alexander featured as Mama Morton in Chicago, and she'll be joined tonight by two of Dracula's handmaidens from Frankenstein's Hans, Clara Milne and Purdy Gerard. They will be performing The Beautiful Trio from Hamilton by Lin-Manuel Miranda. Who lives, who dies, who tells your story?
But before that, we have our first soloist of the evening. Those of you who have been fortunate enough to hear our next performer on the few occasions she has performed in public will not have forgotten her ability to captivate a room. So please give a warm welcome to the stage with Zach Bryan's Something in the Orange to Purdy Gerard.
Thank you. I'll give him this. Hamilton's financial system is a work of genius. I couldn't undo it if I tried. And I tried.
Who lives, who dies, who tells your story?
President Madison, he took our country from bankruptcy to prosperity. I hate to admit it, but he doesn't get enough credit for all the credit he gave us.
Who lives, who dies, who tells your story?
The founding father's story gets told.
Helping other founding father gets to grow old. And when you're gone, who remembers your name?
Who keeps your flame?
Who tells your story?
Who tells your story?
To our vocalists, unfortunately, Hamilton is not going to be an option for next year's musical. Aww. However much it probably would be the first choice of many of our cast tonight.
Moving on. We have a popular a cappellas up next. Bigger in number than ever before, it seems like close harmony singing is having something of a renaissance. Yes. Some of you may have first heard this next number, Words and Music for Remembrance, all the way back in November. With our rendition of Billy Joel's and Serco's, with many in the audience to ask for it again.
Following the a cappellas, you'll have something from the drama department, and along with my co-hosts Sam and Joe, will take to the stage for their final A-level exam piece, which they've chosen to perform. It is an extract from the 2004 play, An Incident at the Border. This extract is the opening of the play, where an innocent incident at the park starts to take on sinister repercussions.
But before for that, please give a very warm welcome to the Ackerfellas.
In every heart. It's over, damn all those beautiful girls. They only want to do you dirt. They'll have you suicidal, suicidal when they say it's over.
If the sky, we look upon, should tumble and fall, and the mountain, should crumble,
to the sea.
I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't
shed a tear.
Just as long as you stand by me.
See, it started at the park, used to chill after dark. Oh, when you took my heart, that's when we fell apart. Cause we both thought that our love would last forever. See, it's very divine, you are one of a kind. But you hush up my mind, you ought to get declined. Oh Lord, my baby is driving me crazy. Your way to beautiful girls, that's why it'll never work. You'll have me suicidal, suicidal when you say it's over. Time all those beautiful girls, they only wanna do you dirt. They'll have you suicidal, suicidal when they say it's over. Don't worry, I'm a
Tough duck. No one tells this duck what to do.
We should. It's amongst the trees.
The water.
Yeah, it tastes different.
Stillness of the water.
Feels like we've left the whole of the real world behind us.
It is so peaceful.
George, I'm going to take a few minutes break. There's some fudge in my pocket I want to eat, and I'd like to get out of it before it melts. Thank you, George. What's that? Flavor? Vanilla?
No, that isn't the border. The border is miles away.
Nah, the water's miles away. We'll move here.
You can't just move a border.
Why not?
I don't know. You just can't.
It did say in the newspaper that not all the terms of independence would be finalised. I suppose that the border move was just one of those details. It also said something about a reduction of powers for certain global forums. But we do get our own national anthem.
Yeah. Wow. You're really
awoke. I try to be.
But so the border's moving here?
Yes.
Right through the park.
Right through the bench.
Right through both the park and the bench and the duck pond. Let's figure out how to get tape through water.
Can't you just use work?
Would that not sink?
Well, not if you put it tight enough, see.
But if you're changing the border, then you're changing the country. You're making the country smaller.
Or bigger.
Or bigger, depending on which side of the border you're on.
That's not up to me. I was just told where to draw the line. George.
My friend on the radio. My superior.
Who told George where to draw it?
Anna. You'd have to ask him.
Can't believe you're moving the border.
I'm not. I'm eating fudge.
What are you up to? That is the fudge.
Lovely. Thank you.
It's a piece of tape. Board, is it?
Obviously it's temporary.
What will it be eventually then?
Some kind of fence. Maybe a wall with a bit of barbed wire so they run on top.
Why is that necessary?
To keep people in or out. It all depends on which side of the barbed wire wall you happen to be on.
So you're trying to tell me that we woke up this morning thinking we belong to a country, and in fact we still do belong to that country, but it is the country itself that has changed.
Suppose so.
So that means if I stood here yesterday, I would have been in my country. But if I stand here today, I am in a different country.
Should I be answering these questions? They sound very rhetorical.
No, yes, you should. I don't sound rhetorical here.
You do.
He does, doesn't he?
Well, we were sat here having a nice, peaceful day in the park.
I haven't stopped you guys.
You're about to divide the duck pond in two.
Yeah, and if those ducks aren't good for them, they'll stay on their side of the line.
Hey.
Somewhere else.
We are going to go and sit somewhere else.
Well, you can't go back.
What?
Can't cross that.
What?
You can't cross the border.
What?
You can't cross the border without permission.
Permission?
Under the terms of the independence, you can't cross the border without permission from the side you are on.
But I am from this country.
This country?
This country!
This country.
That country!
The country I'm in.
You're originally from this country?
Yes!
So you're telling me. So you're from this country, but you went into that one without permission.
And now you want to come back into this one without permission from you!
George, you've got a problem now.
Did you
to disturb you two. You look so controlled.
Just let him cross. He's from this country and he is in danger.
I never said he was dangerous. Oh God.
Well, he is the opposite of dangerous.
Hey! I can be pretty mean if I wanted to. Not for you, man.
Can't cross.
We could make it work for a while.
Ow.
We could...
Olivia!
The bribe of a government official.
No. She wasn't, she didn't mean it. She was joking.
We both understand you have a very important job to do.
Exactly.
You probably should have asked which side of the line I wanted to be on before we put down the border. Maybe I shouldn't. So, you think that means I could cross back over?
No.
A moment in order to recover from their traumatic endeavours. In the meantime, if you wish to see the Acapellas again, you'll have to buy your tickets for the HCS fashion show on Saturday, where those waistcoats may well be making another appearance. Unless the fashion police rule otherwise. And so we are drawing close to the interval, and time for just one more number. We have our music, and dance, and drama. We have to finish off the first half with something that combines all three. The Addams Family started off as a cartoon strip for the TV series and film spin-offs. In 2010, the musical version by Andrew Lipper, Marshall Brickman, and Rick Ellis opened on Broadway and has been a firm favourite of audiences ever since. Now, with our take on When You're an Addams, please welcome our musical theatre ensemble.
Smile at the moment you smell blood.
Oh, woo!
to really stand out. So give us shadows and give us love. Broken glass in a water room.
Something fun. Rolex human, give it all tonight.
And on this special night of the year, we summon our beloved ancestors. Why do we do this?
Because
we're dead.
Family.
Family. And why do we do this?
How?
How do we do this?
By dancing on their graves!
Yes, my brother Festa, dance! Time to wake the dead.
Thank you.